What it is, my Tenno, Peace and Grease here, and today I'm going to be showing you every vengeful ephemera that can drop from a Koopa Lich. Now, currently there are 7 vengeful ephemeras in the game, but undoubtedly there will be more once DE finishes and releases the Corpus Lich system. Now, all of these ephemeras have a 20% drop rate across the board, doubled from their original 10% drop rate. But do not mistakenly assume, because the drop rate has effectively been doubled, that these will drop like rain, because I can most assuredly tell you they will not. It has been an absolutely unholy grind getting each and every one of these ephemeras, and it has taken me 40 Koopa Liches in total to get all of these ephemeras. Point being that if you're looking for a specific ephemera, be prepared to farm anywhere from 1 Koopa Lich to 10 Koopa Liches, or anything in between, to acquire said ephemera. Now, I am using Nidus as a display here, and I'm using 2 different energy colors for his attachments, one being a bright orange and the other being a bright blue, to really show the effects of these ephemeras. So we're just going to start alphabetically and go with Vengeful Charge. Now, this is an electric ephemera, so you're going to need to use an electric progenitor to create your lich. Now, this ephemera is very nice, and it actually takes both the color cues from your energy, as long as you have your Warframe Formud. As you can see here, we have some nice orange as well as blue electric arcs going on here. Very nice little ephemera in general. Next, we have Vengeful Chill. Now, I particularly am not a fan of this ephemera for two reasons. The first is that it doesn't seem to take any kind of cues from your second energy color. And secondly, it seems to apply some type of a skim coat over the top of your Warframe, which in general I'm just not a fan of. Now, this is a cold ephemera, so you will need to be using a cold progenitor to create your lich for this particular ephemera. Next, we have Vengeful Flame, and this is also a very nice little ephemera. Again, takes cues from both of your energy colors, as long as your Warframe has been formed. As you can see here, we've got blue embers floating around, as well as the orange smoke. But this is the heat ephemera, so you will need to be using a heat progenitor to create your lich. Next, we have the Vengeful Pull ephemera. Fun fact about this particular ephemera, it was actually broken when the Koopa Lich system was released. If you imagine a broken steam pipe blasting a high volume of steam out the end, but then apply that to the torso of your Warframe, is what it originally looked like. Now, thankfully, it has been fixed, and it's actually a really nice little ephemera. It does take color cues from both of your energy colors, whereas you have the blue kind of glowing in the torso with these little orange particle effects dancing around your Warframe. Very nice. Now, Vengeful Pull is a magnetic ephemera, meaning that you're going to need to use a magnetic progenitor to create your lich for this particular ephemera. Moving on, we will go to Vengeful Shockwave. Now, Vengeful Shockwave, this one's kind of an odd one. It's not obvious what I'm referring to, let me point it out here real quick. So on each side of your Warframe, about their shoulder, elbow, hip, as well as thigh, there's some type of debris that's kind of glowing around them on both sides. It does seem to take the colors from both of your energy selections, but for whatever reason, it's just, they don't really do anything besides just kind of stay stationary there on your Warframe. I'm not particularly a fan of this particular ephemera, but it is the Vengeful Shockwave ephemera, which is an impact-based ephemera. So you're going to need to be using an impact progenitor to create your lich to get a chance at this particular ephemera. Moving on, we will go to Vengeful Toxin. Vengeful Toxin, very nice little ephemera, nice little energy flow from the feet up towards the head of your Warframe. Does take cues, color cues, from both of your energy squares, your energy selections here. As you can see here, overall, really nice ephemera. I do dig this one. Now, this is Vengeful Toxin, so you're going to need to be using a Toxin Progenitor to create your lich for this particular ephemera. Now, last but certainly not least, we have Vengeful Trickster. Now, Vengeful Trickster is a radiation ephemera, so you're going to need to be using a radiation progenitor to create your lich to get a chance at this ephemera. But While this ephemera is not obnoxious, it does suffer from going too far the other way, and that is that it's barely noticeable. Which, if I go to the trouble of farming an ephemera, I would like it to be noticeable on my warframe, which, as you can tell here, there's just nothing really obvious going on here with my warframe. It doesn't even look like there's an ephemera equipped, if you ignore this smoke effect of the previous ephemeras, obviously. But if you look closer, down towards their feet, their ankles, their hands, even on the back of their heads lightly, you can just kind of see a little bit of kind of energy kind of flowing upward. But it's very vague. It's very, very vague. It's very hard to see in general. But with all of those things said, that is all seven vengeful ephemeras. Let me know down in the comment sections which ones are your favorite. And until next time, peace and grease.